Cellular respiration. So what is cellular respiration? Well, cellular respiration is basically the breakdown of organic molecules such as carbohydrates, fats, and amino acids, which make up proteins, to produce energy. Glucose, which is a simple carbohydrate, is the preferred source for the cellular respiration pathway. In this video, we're going to go through the basics of this process. We're not going to go through every single step in detail, rather a summary of the steps. There are four main stages that take place during cellular respiration. Glycolysis, an intermediate stage, the citric acid cycle, and the electron transport system. An important thing to know is that glycolysis does not require oxygen, making it anaerobic, and the other three stages do require oxygen, making them aerobic. So let's say you eat a banana, which contains glucose, and your body wants to take some of that glucose and convert it to cellular energy. Inside the cytosol of a cell is where the first step, glycolysis, takes place. During glycolysis, a molecule of glucose, which has six carbons, goes through a series of steps which lead to the glucose molecule being converted to two pyruvate molecules. These pyruvate molecules have three carbons each, so six carbon glucose to two 3-carbon pyruvates. During glycolysis, two ATP molecules are invested and four ATP molecules are produced, so a net gain of two ATPs. ATP is the energy currency in cells, so you can think of it like a gas can that provides the fuel to do cellular work. Another key thing is that during glycolysis, two molecules of NADH are produced, and these molecules would be used in a later process. The pyruvates that are produced have two pathways. If sufficient oxygen is available, they will enter into the intermediate stage. And if oxygen is not available, pyruvate is converted to lactate. We will cover this pathway in depth in a later video. Next is the intermediate stage. With oxygen available, the pyruvates will enter a mitochondria, which is an organelle in the cell. Here, pyruvate is converted into acetyl-CoA. Two more molecules of NADH are produced, and a carbon dioxide CO2 molecule is released. Next is the third stage, the citric acid cycle. In the citric acid cycle, acetyl-CoA goes through several steps, leading to the production of one ATP molecule, three NADH molecules, and one FADH2 molecule, as well as the release of two more carbon dioxide molecules. But remember, we started with two acetyl-CoA molecules, so the citric acid cycle must occur twice, which gives a total of two ATPs, six NADHs, two FADH2s, and a total of four carbon dioxide molecules are released. Now for the fourth stage, the electron transport chain. This is where the most ATP production occurs. Here, NADH and FADH2 release electrons, which after a series of steps leads to the production of 32 to 34 ATP molecules. So, in theory, we have two ATPs from glycolysis, two ATPs from the citric acid cycle, and 34 from the electron transport chain, for a total of 38 ATPs produced. However, the actual number is estimated to be between 28 and 30, because some of the processes along the pathway need to use ATP to complete their functions. And so now the path of cellular respiration is complete. So how about other food molecules? Glucose is a simple carbohydrate, and we have seen how it fits into the cellular respiration pathway. But other simple carbohydrates, such as fructose and galactose, can enter the pathway during the glycolysis stage as well. Proteins are made up of amino acids, and most of the time they are not used to produce energy via cellular respiration. However, if the body needs to use amino acids for energy, it can. First, they must have their amino NH2 group removed. Once this is done, different amino acids enter the cellular respiration pathway at different stages. Lipids or fats can also enter the pathway. Triglycerides, the main form of fat, consists of four parts, a glycerol unit and three fatty acids. The glycerol unit can be modified and enter the pathway in the glycolysis stage, and the fatty acids can be broken down further and enter at the citric acid cycle stage. And folks, that be the basics on cellular respiration.